To create a blog post, go to Sites, make sure you're in the Websites area, and then either click the title of this website to go into your settings or create a new website here. Give your website a name. I'm going to go with blog. Click Save and Continue. Choose a group for any forms you might create on your website. Click Save and Continue again. Choose a template. I'm going to go with this real estate one. So this is your website, and this is the website builder. Please see a separate video for that called Website Builder. But if you want a blog, you have to be sure that you actually have a blog on your website. And to create one, click this button here. If you don't have one already, that is. Click Blog and click Save. Now, if you have a website but only want a blog, what you could also do is delete all these pages here and just click this little pencil by the blog and click Set as Homepage. And that's what I'm going to do now. You can edit this blog to your liking by editing this tab here. And when you're done with the edits, click Save and Publish. Here are some of your website settings. Let's change this to blog for the website URL. You can also have a custom one, of course. Just follow the instructions here. And once you're done, click Save and Continue. And here we have even more settings, analytics, domains, etc., etc. But what we're looking for is this blog tab, and let's click that. And here we go. Here we can manage categories. I'm going to add a category called marketing and click create. This is the title that will show up on your website, and this is the slug that will show up in people's browsers. Click save when you're done. There we go. We added the category. We can add more here or go back here or just press blog. This will do the same thing. And we're back. We don't have any posts, of course. We can manage our categories again. Now we can also choose a category. If we have many posts, we can filter them by the categories. And we can create a post by using this button here. Let's give it just the name, first post. Click create once you're done. There we go. These are all the settings, the post title, the slug. We can turn on heat maps here if we want. And we can have a little excerpt if we want. I'm going to actually go ahead and take some text from one of our blogs here. Just going to copy, go back, and paste it in here. Actually, let me add this W back, and let me take away some of this text because it's a little too much for an excerpt. Okay, and let's make the category marketing. I'm going to add a feature image. Let's go with this one here. Of course, we can also upload an image or use URLs, Google Drive, Giphy, or Unsplash. This is cool. We have a lot of free images that you can use here, and you can put whatever you want. For example, if it is a real estate template, we can even go with a house, for example, instead of a motorcycle. And now we can just choose this house here. And that is the featured image. Then click Next. There we go. That's our feature image. And here we can start writing our blog post. So this is the simple editor. We can start typing. I'm actually going to just paste that text into here. And the way you got pasted this time, it depends on where you're copying the text from. But you got each part of this text is like a different block. And you can move these blocks around, edit them separately, or use this little arrow to move things around. And if you want things to go together, what you need to do is copy them from here and just type in here. Now, if you click Enter, you're going to jump to another block. But if you click Shift and Enter, you're going to stay within the same block. Okay? This is helpful if you're changing parts of your text, if you want to move things up and down, but keep the text in some places together. If I press Ctrl Z, my history pops up, and I can undo things or redo things like this. For example, let's go all the way here. The version history will show up after you click Save and Publish and go back in here, and the preview is pretty self-explanatory. But let's go back into this text. Every time I press Enter, I will see something like Start Writing Your Text. But this Start Writing Your Text is not going to be shown to the visitors of your website, so you don't have to worry about that. And of course, you can get rid of it by just clicking Delete or Backspace. Now, this is important for the big chunks because if you want to do something like justify them, you can Control A, highlight everything, and then justify. Now, if you're using your mouse to highlight something, just make sure you're not going too far with your mouse over here. Just make sure you're really close here so you see that. There we go. We want that icon to show because in this case, when you release it, you get this little menu where you can change things around. Like, for example, you can format this to be a heading. You can align it to the center. That's too much text for a heading, but just to give you an example, you can make this go on top. There you go. And then you can, of course, change other things like bold text, italic, have it underline, have a list, add a link. You can just insert a link. You can have it open in another tab. Here's where you put in your link. I'm going to cancel this for now. You can make the size of the text bigger or smaller if you wish. And of course, you can color the text. Let's make it more grayish. Let's go back to, that's too small. Let's go to 16 here. And you can, of course, align it again. Now, besides editing the text, what you can also do is, let's go back down here, click Enter, start a new line. And if we click this plus button, you're going to add more text, an image, or a divider. Let's add a divider here. Let's move it up. And let's just drag it a little further up here. There we go. Now, if you go to these three dots here, you'll have an edit option, duplicate, and trash option. Let's edit it. The sidebar will show, and we can just edit this divider to your liking, change the background, change the color, make it a little lighter if we want, change the size and the design. But actually, I liked it how it was. There we go. And then we can go again, add a plus here, add an image, click the image, choose the image. I know this is a real estate template, but I really like this motorcycle. So I'm going to use this motorcycle here. There we go. And now we can resize this motorcycle. We can have it aligned to the left, to the right. We can add a link here again, or link it to a pop-up, to a landing page, or to an anchor. Click save. But if we don't want it to be like this, for example, we liked it how it was, centered, and we want it to go all the way from edge to edge, but it's a little too big, we can also go ahead and click edit here. This is our third-party editor we use. We can go ahead and transform here, make it a little like this. Remember to click this button here before you click save, and then click save. Now remember, sometimes we need to wait for this to load a little. Just wait, then when you're done, click save. Okay, that's our motorcycle there. Then if you click plus again, you can add a table. With the table, it's very similar to a table in your website. You can add some text here. And again, if you click these three dots and click that edit button, you have a lot more options. Like, for example, you can have more rows, zebra style, fixed width, table header. And again, with the text, you can edit it to your liking, align it center, make it bigger, change the text here, change the link colors, the header if we have one, cancel. But we can also just go straight into here and change the colors over here. Okay, I'm going to delete this because it doesn't look too good with the rest of my design here. Actually, I'll get rid of this. And this divider doesn't work really nicely over here. I'm going to duplicate this just to show you how that works. And I'm going to drag and drop this a little lower. It'll be easier for me just to drop this here. There we go. So that's the blog post. Once you're done, just click save and continue. And here we go. We can unpublish it, look at the details, and edit the post. Now let's see how this looks in the website itself. Let's go to overview. I'm going to copy the URL and I'm going to open it in a new browser window. Here we go. And here are my blog posts. I mean, one of my blog posts. And then more will show up here, right? And then I can use these categories to filter through the blog posts. This makes it easier for your visitors to look at your different blog post types, like marketing, sales, et cetera, et cetera. Or houses, apartments, in the case of real estate, right? And then when I click the post, I'll see that whole post that I edited. And there we go. My post is ready on my website. As simple as that. Well, that's it. Thanks for watching. Have a wonderful day, and I'll see you in the next video. Hey, thanks for watching the video. Please click subscribe. Use the little bell icon. You can also catch us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and of course, use the little subscribe link in the description to sign up to our newsletter. Thanks again, and see you in the next video.